คนพิการสามารถแสดงธรรมะได้อย่างถูกต้อง
Disabled people can practice meditation, and this has inspired others to come and learn Dhamma.
I told those who listen to my Dhamma talks that the secret way to live a happy life is to be at the present moment. Observe and be aware of any emotion arising and to see it as a mental state of mind. This is the shortest way to be free from one's suffering by developing mindfulness.
Although Kampo is disabled, he can still practice Dhamma. The teaching of the Buddha has nothing to do with sex, caste, or physical disability, as can be seen in Kampo. He is a role model for those who are interested in practicing Dhamma. As long as you have awareness, you can practice. This is an inspiration for others to come and practice. For those who have a normal body, should practice Dhamma without delay.
From my understanding, Kampo is a noble person without wearing robe.
He is disabled and yet he practices and achieves high attainment.
If can be exchanged, I won't mind being disabled if I can attain such state of mind.
Kampo is a special person. He inspired me to practice.
I feel sad for him, but he has strong determination to practice.
Kampo can do it, I can do it too.
He still has the ability to end his mental suffering.
I won't regret to be like him if I can attain such level.
Many occasions, Lumpo took me along for Dhamma talks as a role model to encourage people to come and practice Dhamma. I saw transformation in my life. Though I am disabled, I want to make myself useful and be able to help others spiritually. That is the best thing I can do for the society. Being a handicap, it is instrumental for me to inspire others to practice Dhamma. At least, I can instill others to practice Buddha's teachings. I am not good in giving Dhamma talks, and I am also a handicap. People pity me, and when they see me, this gives them the calmness. I also consider this a Dhamma. In my present life, I have decided to help and encourage others to practice. I inspire those who are discouraged and without willpower and give them confidence so that they can walk the Dhamma path. In my daily life, I continue to develop mindfulness in thought, speech, and action. At the same time, I also introduce Dhamma to others and encourage those who are discouraged not to give up life easily and to practice awareness. Whatever I do, I do not expect any rewards, and I do not want to become somebody. I always encourage others not to give up hope easily, so that they can develop the awareness.
Although he is disabled, he is cheerful, and he is free from suffering. He practices what he preaches.
It's my duty and responsibility to share Dharma talks with Kalyana Mitras and help them to build their faith and confidence in Dharma. The past few years, my life was a nightmare. It's just a nightmare for me, and now I'm awake. There won't be any nightmare for me. And I will never go back to the nightmare again. Now I'm awake, and as thought, nothing had happened. My duty now is to take care of my body and mind through awareness. Awareness helps to intercept thoughts, so that the mind does not dominate by thoughts, to the point of losing its state of normality. My other duty is to inspire others without expectation when opportunities arise. I live in the present moment, no regrets about past and no worries about the future. My mind is now at the state of normality. Today, my life is full of happiness.
The Dharma is realized, enriches a man's heart. The fruit of this realization is the noble thing, the valuable wisdom. Keep contemplating at any time, without delay. When the mind is still and deeply calm, then the Dharma is realized.
Thank you. พระบาทยาตราคือจารึกปลุกสำนึกคืนกลับจากหลับไหลทรงชี้ทางบรรเทาทุกข์ชี้สุขใจแล้วฉะไหนเรามัวเพลินไม่เดินตามเสถียรพงศ์วรรณปก